I mentioned earlier that RVM provides opportunities for the developer to give hints to the library on optimizing the performance of the library for the chosen application. In other words, the transaction semantics of RVM is already a stripped-down version of the traditional transaction semantic. It doesn't worry about nested transactions and so on, but still, transaction by its very nature requires that at commit point, you have to do a synchronous I/O to the disk. And similarly, transaction by its very nature says that it has an all or nothing property. So if the transaction is not going to commit, that is, it is going to abort, then we have to make sure that all the changes that have been made between begin transaction and abort transaction are thrown away. And similarly, if the transaction commits, then we have to make sure that at the commit point, all the changes that have been made to in-memory copies of persistent data structures are committed to the disk. That's where synchronous I/O comes in. But if the developer wants to optimize his performance, RVM gives opportunities for such optimizations. The first opportunity is the no restore mode in the begin transaction call. The no restore mode in begin transaction is signaling to RVM that this transaction that I'm starting is not going to abort. And therefore, there is no need for you to create an in-memory undo record for me. Even though I'm going to give you a set range call, don't bother creating an undo record for the range of addresses that I intend to modify in this begin transaction. That's what is meant by the no restore mode. So that reduces the amount of work that RVM has to do in doing a memory copy, and the application is going to gain because RVM is doing less work, which means the overhead in performing a transaction is going to be less as seen by the application. The second optimization opportunity is the no flush mode in the end transaction. As I mentioned, a transaction truly has committed only when the changes to the critical section between begin transaction and end transaction have been synchronously written out to the disk. So the normal semantic of an end transaction, that is a commit of a transaction, would require that RVM should block the process that made that call for end transaction until that redo record has been written synchronously to the disk. But if the application developer is opportunistic and believes that the chances of failure, either due to power failure or due to his own software crashing, is pretty small, he could be brave enough to say no flush mode. And what that no flush mode is telling the RVM library is that there is no need to do a synchronous I/O. Of course, I want you to write it to the disk, but don't block me in order to write to the disk. So no need to do the synchronous flush of the redo log to the disk. And in other words, what we are getting by doing a no flush mode in end transaction is lazy persistence. We know it is going to be persisted on the disk. That is the work that RVM is going to do. But it is not doing it exactly at the point of end transaction. So the upshot is there is a window of vulnerability. End transaction happened here. And maybe by the time RVM gets to write it out to the disk, so much time has elapsed. So this time window is the window of vulnerability. So if this axis is time, then end transaction happened here, and this is the point where the redo record was committed to the disk. So this is the portion which we're calling as a window of vulnerability, and the app developer is taking a chance, saying that I am so sure that no crash is going to happen in this window, I'm going to go ahead and say no flush. So in other words, the transaction is being used as an insurance. And this should remind you of the old adage that we saw when we talked about shared memory systems. Shared memory systems scale really well when you don't share memory. Similarly, transactional systems scale really well, perform really well, when you don't use the full semantic requirement of transaction. In particular, if you can get rid of synchronous I/O, it'll make the performance better.